I'll be with you boys in a minute. He was better than Captain Clay. He better than Sugar Ray. He better than that. Who that? You, the new boy they got. Mike Tyson. Look like a bulldog. He better than him, too. He done whipped Mike Tyson's ass. He whipped all their asses.
What about Rocky Marciano?
Let me tell you something once and for all. Rocky Marciano was good. But compared to Joe Louis, Rocky Marciano ain't shit.
He beat Joe Louis's ass.
Pacquiao, so that a big...
This has a good left hook. It's not his money punch.
Good right hand by... Type guy in the corner.
Victor Polo, this is the move. There's the fall. The big right by... I missed that, but Steve, that's the trick.
Oh, now he's mixed. They go toe-to-toe. Martinez getting the better.
You know, that...
And a dull counter vote. Salido.
2003, and lots of talent.
And he's scoring. Have exhibited explosive power. Speaking of power, the right hand by Marquez. And that's a knockdown.
4, 5, 6, 7.
In front as we enter round 8. And like there, straight right. Oh, a left right. The lighter
was great.
That's the way. Another one by Marquez. And another. Well pointed out by both the IBF and WBA.
Most people believe, oh, this is a dilemma. I need to attack more, but when I attack, I can hit with punches like that.
So Marquez scoring at will. A beautiful series of punches. And this is his end in round 7.
He's very quick.
There's a left hook. Assault by Marquez. A masterful boxing performance by the champion Juan Manuel Marquez, hearing it from the crowd.
A sense of nationalism and pride from Chavez's loyal followers. Thousands of folks from Mexico coming up for the big fight here in Las Vegas. And this huge gathering here at the Thomas & Mack Center, anxiously awaiting the start of the fight, Julio Cesar Chavez versus Hector Macho Camacho.
Camacho looks like a guy that's standing under a cliff waiting for it to fall on. What a workman is Chavez.
Oh, he landed with the right, did Chavez. Two words, all Chavez. Camacho is just taking a beating.
Well, Chavez said he wanted to give him a beating. He didn't just want to knock him out. And that's what he's getting now, a beating.
Steps out and throws 3 or 4 fast punches as if he wants to start fast, blocking shots upstairs with his gloves.
A little bit unusually confident, a little bit arrogant and cocky even in this fight, the way it's starting off.
There's no loop in Miguel Cotto's right hand.
No, he's a good puncher. He does a variety of everything. Batted punches, head punches.
And he's been surprisingly effective with it, particularly against Zab Judah. And he wobbles Gomez with a left hook to the body, the trademark punch of Miguel Cotto.
That almost looked like a jab to me.
When you look at the marks already on Gomez's face, it suggests to you the authority with which Cotto is landing out there.
Yeah, Cotto's had a lot of punches. It's most effective that hard, stiff left jab, though, that he's been.
Good left hook to the body again by Miguel Cotto.
I think he just feels really comfortable in this fight. He just seems to be very relaxed and just having fun out there. I've never saw him so confident and relaxed.
And Cotto's treating this like a sparring session, Emmanuel.
Yeah, because I don't think he feels that Gomez can punch you. Heard of it. One thing we know, Cotto does get hurt. So, but one thing, he gets up and he fights. Margarita for herself, he can get hurt.
Well, this is a knockdown of Gomez. Gomez looked at the referee as if to say, he didn't hit me with a punch, I just fell. Then Cotto got credit for a knockdown without landing his punch. But I saw Mike Tyson get credit for a knockout against Carl the Truth Williams without ever landing a punch. Williams just fell down 3 times. Yeah, still hasn't been down from contact, but he has absorbed a lot of punishments in the first two rounds against Miguel Cotto. Gomez trying for more head movement now. Uppercut snaps Gomez's head up in his face. Right hand lands for Cotto.
Left uppercuts, jabs, or anything for the center.
Well, he's fallen in love a little bit with the idea of doing more boxing since the moment.
That was a left hook. Body shots like that are very difficult to weather.
Now that's a real knockdown. Cotto came out in this round as though he wanted to test just how hurt Gomez is and whether he can get him out of here.
Once again, to emphasize a point that Larry made in round two, Alfonso Gomez had never been knocked down and has never been knocked out in his professional career. And this despite the fact that in the Contender Series 3 years ago, he was fighting fighters who were naturally 10, 12, 15 pounds bigger than
fighters.
Well, this is reminiscent of what Cotto did to Carlos Quintana here in Atlantic City a year and a half ago. Quintana, who now has a title belt, a very skilled fighter, a guy who beat an outstanding young puncher from South America named Joel Julio, and Cotto annihilated him with body shots.
You think Cintron could fight Gomez?
Yeah, I mean, they could fight. They would be a good fight, but really, right, he doesn't have the power to stand in that trade with Joel Cotto.
Is Gomez showing too much courage, Emmanuel, or does he have no choice?
I think his corner's going to have to stop this fight because he's not the type of guy to
He's
stop.
Getting hurt badly. This is the kind of stuff that affects your career.
Yeah, and he doesn't have enough power.
And he's just being beaten to the punch consistently.
I've said it many times, Miguel Cotto doesn't just beat you, he beats you up. Three fighters among his last eight opponents have not fought again. Just go out and throw everything. That would seem to be an unwise tack to take. Down goes Gomez for the third time in the fight. He's a shell of the person who came into the ring. The doctor's going to stop the fight. We're done. There will be no round six.
Oh, crushing right by the touchdown.
So much money.
この右、そして左、西岡の左を警戒してるんです。もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう一回、もう
You got to use that jab. Look at the hands of Morales. Big right hand.
Morales is in trouble. Roller kicks the right and the left, and he's up against the ropes. He nearly goes down. Referee lets it continue. He could have called that a knockdown. The ropes holding up Rafael Morales. A left hook by Zero. Morales in deep trouble. He needs to hold or answer back with something, but he's in terrible trouble here as Costa Zoo goes to work, as he always does in the first round. Zoo opening up with a bombing here of Rafael Morales in the first round. A terribly rocky round for Rocky.
And you know that
right hand by Zoo, and that was a big one. Ebb and flow to this first round.
Big
right hand. And Zoo looking for an opening. You see it offensively here. It's Costa Zoo. Beautiful right hand by Zoo, and that shakes up Morales immediately. Morales in big trouble up against the ropes. Again, his legs sagging. And Zoo there with the presence of mind to go to the body, and he's looking for the finish
time,
right now.
It's time. At what point? Already from the right glove.
Oh, Morales takes a terrible right hand. A brutal shot by Zoo. And Zoo with a left hand really has Morales in a bad way. I can't believe Rafael stayed on his feet.
Hurts.
Morales, who comes right out immediately and jumps right on Morales. Lands a big left hook. Morales in trouble right away against the ropes. Ready to go down. It's time for the referee to stop the fight.
Absolutely.
Stop the fight, please.
Stop it.
He is in terrible shape, and Goosen comes in to stop the fight.
Yeah.
That was referee Luis Guzman looking at.
To keep his hands up. And a right hand stands him up again. Extremely sharp. Round one, all Marvin Hagler. What's not her? Middleweight championship of the world. Hagler right to work with the right hand again against Hamcho. And again.
I'd rather fight him on the outside.
Really going here. Marvin Hagler looking extremely sharp. And Jake LaMotta liking the Harry grip. Hamshaw also.
He is being a great champion.
And Marvin continues, is just fighting like a man possessed right now. Another right hand actively here. Blood from both eyes of the challenger. Hagler again. Most of the damage is on the right eye. And he thinks
that was pretty much a boxing mess. You don't see all his brains.
Because we are almost a minute into this round, the left eye. The right eye seems to be cut underneath
the left wing. Whoopings combination. What an impressive pass.
Being like a surgeon, and Hamshaw has taken it off. Three punches right on the nose. Downstairs on the right hand to score with the left hand a little bit now. And a combination once again by Marvin Hagler. Hamshaw's back in the corner. Uppercut just stood the head of Mustafa Hamshaw, snapped it right back. And a combination again, another right hand. Crowd comes alive. And another right hand to the face of Hamshaw. Right. And now a right hand to the body of Hamshaw. Hamshaw has Spanaker, who is now stalking Hamshaw. Left hand to the wrist and right to the face. Hamshaw back. Right hand again, and another right hand. And Hamshaw's legs right to the face. And the eyes continue to bleed of Mustafa Hamshaw. Hagler combination scoring it well right now. Just trying to measure, keep him away. Hagler scores with the right hand, even so. And another right hand, and yet another. Combinations of punches by the champion. Tries to go downstairs, comes up, a right hand step, and back. Hamshaw is against the ropes, takes another right hand, and an uppercut. Hamshaw's corner is up, and they are saying, that's it, that's all. Braverman is saying, stop it. The referee does so, the fight is over, and Marvin Hagler is retained his undisputed middleweight championship in the world. What can you say?
You can't say anything, but this guy is truly Hagler. Greatest middleweight in the world. Without a question.
Herrera is way more commanding tonight in the early going.
He has that same facial expression that he had on his face when he fought Nassim Ahmed. He's extremely determined tonight. He's fighting with that same determination tonight. Same intensity.
And another good right hand to the body. Herrera lands two left hooks upstairs. He seems to be taking a little bit of a risk. And a left hook to the body that
personal demons. Just trying to get himself motivated to fight and quit thinking so much and quit being too safe.
And now Barrera is getting three shots with the jab because of that closing right eye. Made Juarez miss, ripped him with in which the pace and the action.
I think that Barrera just came in.
We have some viewers who still wonder what ring generalship is. Is this it?
Absolutely.
Not bad. Juarez needed violence. Barrera is putting on a craft.
He's put on a good clinic tonight. He hasn't got a scratch on his face.
Oh, good left hook by Barrera. Training camp because of fires at Big Bear. Right. How's that tonight?
Well, it was a close fight, but I'm
2-1 advantage over Morales.
Probably not. And he goads Juarez down the stretch.
Putting on a Muhammad Ali performance.
As if to say, where were you? Where were you tonight?
Well,
you want to talk again about what happened in L.A.?
Because he's
kind of bringing the
Zurich is not going to stay away from Martinez.
Sergio Martinez fight seems occasionally large.
Very good defensive fighter here. Zurich, without Zurich's stake against
his favorite right hooks. I mean, Sergio had bigger numbers. Oh. And since Zurich dropped a knee, there's a knockdown for Martinez.
Oh. All right, Harold, now take us to your scorecard.
Attention, 3 rounds, 3-0, Martinez.
Been knocked down. What does that little dip of the knee do to his confidence?
It definitely
has shown the energy to do this for 12 rounds.
Good hard left hand shot.
Aroused a lot of excitement.
Hey, yeah.
Down goes the Zurich again. Second knockdown of his career. And he's getting hammered by a terrific fighter.
Fighter like Zurich to this after destroying Paul Williams.
Roy. Is it possible that a guy's punching power suddenly escalates to a dramatically higher level at age 35 and 36.
Doesn't have no better sense or no better knowledge than to stay straight ahead.
Realizing that he's well behind on the scorecard.
Doesn't feel as
there he is.
There's the third knockdown of the fight.
Don't make it up this time.
This time, Zurich is very badly hurt.
It was different. It wasn't an overhead level. It was a straight level.
Down goes Zurich again. And this may soon be over with.
See, that's just too much.
And he don't have sense enough to move or run away right now, because that's just not his style. His style
is this is over, and this is an amazing performance.
Maybe Sergio Martinez's most impressive performance to date. It is impossible to look good against Zinzurek. He just looks sensational. You know, he's taking Donaire to school a bit here in these three rounds, these first three rounds so far.
Sorry, 90-81, 9 rounds to nothing, Guillermo Rigondeaux. Jim, this guy is terribly prepared, just terribly. I don't know if he hit his feet big or what. The guy throws 4 or 5 punches, and Donaire doesn't throw one. I mean, Nonito Donaire is not in his rhythm yet.
I don't think for a second that Nonito Donaire ever fully understood what he was up against here tonight. It's just that Rigondeaux is all that, and everything his amateur record suggested is true.
This is Wright's attempt to say, I'm the bigger, stronger man. Wright with a solid little right hook inside, just busted Shane, right? Grinning through much of round one.
This is the computer print out of what Jay Moses should not be fighting tonight, is Winky Wright. This is his day to shine.
Most boxing fans probably expected it would be a big night for Shane Mosley. Instead, it appears to have been a big night for his opponent, Winky Wright.
A good left hook to the body by Hopkins and a good right hand upstairs.
He's concerned about the jab, but he did win the jab.
Good left hook by Hopkins there. Havlick so far has been far between, and Havlick's legs are stiffened by a Hopkins uppercut.
This is what I said.
Hopkins again beats him to the punch.
Right on his head.
Love by Hopkins. Strongest virtues.
Good left hook up between the gloves by Hopkins. Rips Havlick with his left hook again.
What happens in this last half minute could determine.
Good left hook by Bernard. Hasn't even landed a solid body shot. Good right hand by Mount, the offense he wants. Again, guys, now into the fifth round. You would think to yourself, there's no way that Hopkins is the guy who lost twice.
He's putting boxing skills in here, and this is something that Kelly's not that good with boxing.
Hopkins has gone over 9 rounds 24 times, and I'll show that injustice of the left hook.
Bernard's having a picnic in there, and it seems like mentally he's getting recharged now.
Still has the faster hands.
Yep.
He still dominates the center of the ring. He's still ripping Pavlik in combination and putting him on the defensive. The crowd loves it.
What is
Hopkins for holding? And he never wants Hopkins. And then give him.
Well, but I think it's a clean fight.
Well, I'm saying, save my smother with the short punches.
He's pushing blow to the image of the younger generation. Gets ripped by a right hand, staggered in the center of the ring. The question is, can Pavlik make it to the finish line?
Bernard is very smart. I just like the fact that he started out at the very beginning and has fought for 4 or 12 rounds in a fight. He was a big underdog, youth, everything. Unbelievable.
Look at the difference in hand speed. This is a landslide for Hopkins.
You see, I don't do things like that. You see, I fight safety. I take my time.
Most did Hopkins gather? Almost all of them.
Where are you guys at? Real fast, real fast.
Much has been made about Manny Pacquiao's foray into the lightweight division. Tonight, he challenges for a title belt in his very first outing at the 135-pound weight limit.
Wait, a spectacular athlete from beginning to this point of his career. Never once has he looked out of place in any weight class in which he's fought. The body just keeps getting better and better.
Pacquiao's speed is just right at this stage is too much, and that's the difference in the fight. Not only is he boxing, but he's doing a variety of things. He's jabbing, he's doing right hooks, right uppercuts, left hands over top. He's doing so many different things.
He looks spectacular, and he's doing it against a southpaw after not having fought one for years. The speed and skill of Manny Pacquiao is amazing to behold. A southpaw Jack Dempsey in the lightweight division. A non-stop aggressor with speed and power beyond compare. How many more? Down he goes, and Dracula stops the fight.
He should have never got to that.
decision.
Manny Pacquiao was sensational tonight. He put on a clinic, and it proved that he was much more than just a power puncher.
Joe Lewis's ass.
Pacquiao, so not a big.
This has a good look.
A left punch. The lighter
looks great.
That's the way. Another one by Marquez, and another. Two straight.
Job pointed out by both the IBF and WBA.
Most people believe, this is the dilemma, I need to attack more, but when I attack, I can hit with punches like that.
So Marquez scoring at will, a beautiful series of punches. And this is his eyes in round seven.
He's very quick.
There's a left hook by Marquez. A furious assault by Marquez. Masterful boxing performance by the champion Juan Manuel Marquez. Hearing it from...
And Miguel Cotto steps out and throws three or four fast punches as if he wants to start bad, blocking shots upstairs with his gloves.
A little bit unusually confident, a little bit arrogant and cocky even in this fight, the way it's starting off.
There's no loop in Miguel Cotto's right hand.
No, he's a good puncher. He does a variety of everything. Body punches, head punches.
And he's been surprisingly effective with it, particularly against Zab Judah. And he wobbles Gomez with a left hook to the body. The trademark punch of Miguel Cotto.
That almost looked like a jab to me.
It's not his money punch.
Good right hand by
type guy in the corner.
Victor Polo, this is the move. There's the follow. The big right by Mar missed that. But Steve, that's the trick. Oh, now it's mixed.
They go toe to toe. Marquez getting the better.
You know, that.
And a dull counter to Salido.
2003 and lots of talent.
And he's scoring. Have exhibited explosive power. Speaking of power, the right hand by Marquez.
Three,
and that's enough.
Four, five, six, seven.
In front as we enter round eight. Hands like there. Straight right. The crowd.
Your sense of nationalism and pride from Chavez loyal followers. Thousands of folks from Mexico coming up for the big fight here in Las Vegas. And this huge gathering here at the Thomas & Mack Center, anxiously awaiting the start of the fight, Julio Cesar Chavez versus Hector Macho Camacho.
Camacho looks like a guy that's standing under a cliff waiting for it to fall on. What a workman is Chavez.
Oh, he landed with the right, did Chavez. Two words, all Chavez. Camacho is just taking a beating.
Well, Chavez said he wanted to give him a beating. He didn't just want to knock him out. And that's what he's getting now, a beating.